That's like decent, like shit.
Oh, I didn't see you there.
That was good.
We came here to Nolly's house in Bath, in his attic. He's got this lovely studio. Not far from where I live, so it's good for me, comfortable. Nice homely vibe. And he just seemed like the guy who knew what I wanted and all of us wanted in our heads, I guess, like for the tones and response and tightness and everything. So yeah, couldn't be happier, really. Turned out amazing.
It was amazing working with him. He knows his stuff, he knows exactly what he's talking about, and it was great having someone with that knowledge behind him.
Working with Nolly was amazing. He's such a talented guy, and he's actually taught me a lot as well about playing and getting the best out of my instrument. You know, he's really captured the sound that we're going for on this album. Just to make it as heavy as possibly can, the end result's just been better than we could ever imagine, so really, really happy with it.
So wee, man. Guitars are so wee.
It's been a real cool project to be involved with. The music's great, the guys have done an amazing job with the pre-production. I think they recorded at least one whole version of the album themselves. They played a lot of these things through countless times in the rehearsal room, so tracking them was a real joy. It took very little work indeed. They all knew all their parts extremely well, and I think that comes across in the final recording. It's very confident and allowed them to really concentrate on the quality of the performances, which is what's important. It's got a basic setup that I have here, just in the attic of my house, but seems that the guys are pretty happy with the result, so hopefully you guys are too.
No.
No.
That was alright.
Not bad.
Guitar, he's one of Nolly's Black Machine B2s. It's a little beauty. Bare knuckles. Straight into Nolly's Axe FX 2 here, which some of you are going to love and some of you are going to hate.
I mean, we've never been happy with the guitar sound on any of our albums before. We really needed to step it up. This being the third album, and we used Axe FX 2 on this album, which is something we've never done before. I mean, we've been using the Axe FX Ultras live for a while now, but before we've always used like tube heads, like a PV head and mic'd up a cab and stuff, but we just wanted to try something different, and after hearing some of the examples of tones that Nolly sent across to us beforehand, we knew it was the right way to go.
Recorded with Nolly's Dingwall bass. I think the tone of the bass sits really nice with the guitars as well on the album. So much better than I've ever recorded before, even in the last album. Sound incredible.
Right, so this has been the song. We want a bit of a telephone effect on it, so rather doing it with an EQ or something, we thought we'd actually use a telephone and see how it comes out. Cool.
The way we approached recording the guitars for this album was a bit different as well. We tried to do a song a day, so I would do my parts, Martin would do his parts, Davey would do his bass parts. So we'd have a finished song by the end of the day, and then we'd add in any lead parts or any layers or anything that any of us could think of. It was a really comfortable setup, and it felt right. Nothing was rushed and we didn't feel any pressure on us.
We're pretty smooth. We did the drums in Wales, as people know, like I did that in Mono Valley with Ron Nash, and then straight to here. It only took about 5 days to do the drums altogether. I think we spent 4 weeks on guitars, and then finishing off little bits here and there.
It has been a bit unusual the way we've approached recording. It's been a collaboration with all these different producers, and it's really worked out for us. Like, we're really happy with the vinyl mixes and how it sounds. It sounds so natural. Like, it hasn't got that clinical modern metal sound that you hear so much of these days. It almost sounds like a live band, and you can really hear the performances.
It's also been an honour for me to be involved with guys like Logan Mader, who's mixing it, also Ramesh, who tracked the drums, big fan of his stuff, and Ginge, who's doing the vocals. So for me, it's a really important project to be a part of, and I'm very glad that the guys asked me to do it.
Writing an album with Martin as well, like, he's really brought something to the band that we needed.
This album's actually, well, my first album with the band. It's the first time the band have really attempted guitar solos, I guess, really. Like, it's something that I've always been into with players that influence me, and I've never really gone for that kind of reach before, so I decided to push myself a bit more. So did Goonzi. But with certain songs, there was ideas I couldn't get across, and I couldn't think of, because I was only like really learning, basically baby steps of how to approach being the lead player, I guess, which is obviously Nolly's expertise as a fantastic guitar player, as most of you probably know. So we actually decided it'd be really cool if Nolly did a guest solo on the album, so we've done that. It's cool, as well as solos by myself and Goonzi on it, and something really stepped up, I think, guitar-wise anyway, with riffs and things, like, it just seemed to be that bit more.
With this album, we've had a lot of time to write the tracks and work on the tracks and make them exactly the way that we want them to be. Me and Martin would write riffs, record them at home, because he stays down in Bath and we'd obviously up in Glasgow. We just email riffs back and forward to each other and build up songs that way, and then Martin would come up and we'd all go into the studio together and piece the songs together as a band. And I think that's important, to get everyone's input on the songs. We wouldn't sound the way we do if we didn't have those five inputs into the song. Loads of groove. That's the thing we wanted to concentrate on, is the groove, like writing riffs that make you really just want to bang your head and enjoy it, and just having fun writing the songs as well. Like, that's another way we approach the writing, is to think about how the songs would come off live, and we're going to be playing these songs for the next however many years, so we need to make sure that they're enjoyable songs to play and that they're going to work live. So I've really tried to keep that in mind and taking inspiration for all types of metal, not just limiting ourselves to anything, like trying to explore loads of new ideas that we never have done in the past.
As far as riffs and music and everything, I think it's grown dramatically from where the band was before. It's just metal. All these people ask me what we think we are. We're a metal band. Like, you know, we just play riffs that we like.
This is definitely some of the most mature stuff we've ever written as a band. It's really dynamic, it's got a lot of heavy, heavy riffs in it.
I think we've really found our passion and found our sound with the songs on this album. We've been working hard on this album for the past 2 years, and this kind of defines everything this band is about, and it's hopefully going to be a big year for us, and I can't wait to get the album out and let everyone hear the songs, let everyone know what we've been up to for the past 2 years. We're really happy with how it came out, and hopefully everyone will enjoy it.
You won't live to see it!